Alright. I've been listening to Nancy Grace. That's the only choice I have. She is furiously backpedaling and blaming everybody but herself. Nancy Grace is just one of many talking heads that no longer are truth tellers. And the confusion on the part of the public has been largely in point as the fault of the talking heads on TV that are deliberately and have been deliberately deceiving the public for ratings. You know, those of us back here that were in the background doing research, we knew that the public was being deceived and did our very best to reveal what was really going on, but we're no match for this maverick media that is just a real problem. Now, why the jury voted not guilty? The answer is very simply, can be explained by the lack of sufficient evidence in key points. Like, example, there was in the car trunk, that was the supposed method of transporting a dead body. There should have been absolutely tons of DNA in that trunk from a decomposition. There wasn't. The absence means that you can only understand this, that no decomposing body was ever in the trunk. There were no fingerprints in this crime. There has to be fingerprints, blood, DNA, when you have remains. And you have, you know, we don't know where this murder occurred. Now, what we can say at this point is Casey Anthony was not the murderer. Absolutely was not the murderer. Because of where there should have been evidence, there wasn't. We have a pretty good idea of who was the murderer. But we shall find this out pretty soon. But anyway, those of you who are absolutely dumbfounded, I certainly understand very much what you have been led to believe and how confused you must be that reaching out in angry ways. But when you have a case that should have lots and lots of scientific evidence, and there's nothing, that means the crime didn't happen there. So right then and there, you got your first red flag, and there was a series of red flags that somebody else did this murder, and it wasn't Casey. And you also have the clue that somebody who was very sophisticated and did cleanup, a specialized cleanup. It isn't just a soap and water type thing or putting stuff in the washing machine. There was a lot that should have been there that wasn't. And that's what the jury could not convict with obvious omissions like this. Should have been tons and tons of DNA. A little bit further is something may happen tomorrow. Today is Tuesday. And yeah, all right, maybe Thursday. We may know more. We may even find out who killed little CAYLEE. whether they open up these sealed envelopes or not is the big question. Things have been held from the public and the jury. You know, the jury doesn't know what's in those sealed envelopes. They found her not guilty because there's no evidence that ties her to the CAYLEE'S final resting place. They were unable to connect any dots because no dots existed. Do you follow me? Anyway, on Thursday, they'll be sentencing on these lesser charges of her lying to law enforcement. I would not be a bit surprised if they re-examine that and drop those charges. Those few ones. But I hope they don't drop them before opening up those sealed envelopes. For one thing, there's photographs in there that may be extremely condemning.